Hey, this is Max here. So last week I got a comment from Arthur, and Arthur said, "What confuses me most is how to handle errors in IntegraMod." So in this tutorial, I want to explain how to handle errors in IntegraMod. It's a little bit techy, but I'm really going to explain it step by step. So let's just dive right in. So over here, you see a simple scenario. So this tutorial is not so much about what this scenario is about, but what to do when something goes wrong in any of these modules and we get an error. Then how do you handle that error automatically? So over here, we have a webhook. So we're receiving data. In this case, we're receiving data from this tool. It's called Postman. And I'm just using this so that I can basically fake send some data over to IntegraMod so that we can quickly test this scenario a couple of times, but this can be anything, right? Then we create or update a contact inside ActiveCampaign, and then we add a row to a Google Sheet. You can see the Google Sheet over here. So we have a name, an email address, and we can also add a note if we want to. So right now, this is set up perfectly, so there should not be any errors. So I also turned it on over here. So now when I'm going to send some data, so we're sending some data, then it takes a second. So we go over here, and then what you can do is we go over here to history, and then you see that we now have one success run. It took a second and three operations. So now here I can go to details, and then you also see here we have all these green check marks. So everything went right. So here we got the data here, emma.doe@gmail.com. That's also the data that we sent over here. First name, last name, email, emma.doe@gmail.com, right? Then the contact was created inside ActiveCampaign and a row was added to the Google Sheet. You can also see that over here. So everything went fine. But now let's break something and then see how we can automatically handle that error. So we go back over to the diagram, we go over here, we edit this. And now imagine that maybe you selected the wrong connection with like old API credentials so that we get like an authorization error because ActiveCampaign in this case says like, hey, you are not allowed to be here. So here I click OK, I click Save, and I leave this to on. And now see what happens when we get an error. So here I send some new data, send it, then it takes a second again. We go back over here, then I will refresh this page. And then now you see that it says the scenario was deactivated because of an error. Scenario has been deactivated because of an error while processing the scenario. Fix the scenario or clear the queue. So when you get an error, now we also see it down here, by the way. So here we have success, here we have error, right? Then when you have an error, the whole scenario just gets disabled so that if more data gets sent from now on, nothing will happen with that data. So that could be really bad depending on what you want to do. So maybe you want to automatically handle that error. So here, when we click details, we can also see what went wrong. We go over here and then we just say, okay, 403 error code. Now that says nothing in this case, but we know, okay, hey, we don't have access. So obviously you could fix this now, but let's not fix it and then see how we could maybe create like an alternative path. So what you could do is you can add an error handling route. So when we right mouse click this module, so we are saying like, okay, if something goes wrong in this module, then we wanna add an error handler. And when you add an error handler, you can do all kinds of things. You can either just create an alternative path. So you could say, okay, when there's an error here, usually it would just stop and not go over to this module. But now if there's an error here, what we wanna do is we wanna add a row to our Google Sheet. Here, add a row, and then we want to add a note that says like, hey, something went wrong over there. So here, let me find my spreadsheet, example sheet, sheet one. Table contains headers. Headers, in case you don't know, that's everything in this first row. So A is name, B is email, C is note. So here, name, I'm going to add the first name, space, and then also the last name, email, I'll add the email. And then a note, here we say, Error occurred in scenario. Not sure if I'm writing occurred right. No, doesn't really matter. So here, error occurred in scenario. Okay, click save. And then now, so I will just leave it disabled for now, but what you can also do for testing purposes, you can also click here, run once. And then here it says process existing because we still have that error that is waiting in the queue because we had an error. So we just click here, process existing. Then the same data is going in it again. And then you see here, we get the same error. So here we have runtime error 403, okay. But In this case, this scenario doesn't get deactivated because the scenario basically was a success because we created an alternative path in case there was an error. So here now the row was added here, emma.gmail.com, error occurred in scenario, but nothing happened with ActiveCampaign because we got this error. And also this error handling path, what is really handy, you can recognize these with these different lines. Like this one is completely filled, right? And this is just an outline. So yeah, that is something you can do. What you can also do is you can also use one of the directives, they call it. So over here, there's also an help article that explains all this. I'm also going to link to this in the description below if you want to check it out. But we have a couple of different error handling directives. And when I saw these for the first time, I found them very, very confusing. So maybe you have the same. So then right now I will go over all these directives one by one. And then you will see they're actually not that difficult at all. So here we have 5 different directives. We have 3 directives where the scenario execution will continue. So it will not like stop right away. So we have resume, which allows you to specify a substitute output for the module with the error and the scenario execution status is marked as success. So I will show you that in a bit. Then ignore simply ignores the error and the scenario execution status is marked as success. So again, the scenario will not disable in that case. Or we say break, and I think that's maybe the most confusing one, that stores the input into the queue of the incomplete executions and the scenario execution status is marked as a warning. So we have success, warning, error. Those are the 3 different statuses of that I know. And then you have 2 other ones. The scenario execution should be stopped. We have rollback. Rollback stops the scenario execution immediately and marks its status as error. And then we have commit. Commit stops the scenario execution immediately and marks its status as success. So let's just do these one by one, right? So here we'll start with this. Resume allows you to specify a substitute output for the module. So here we just click right mouse click again, add an error handler. And then instead of like adding another app or tool, we can use one of the directives up here. So you see all these. So the first one that we want to do is resume. So resume is this one. And then you see that we get this icon. We still get this like outlined line that you can recognize like, hey, this is an error handling route, right? And what resume basically asks us to do or allows us to do is to basically send some data or set data from the outcome of this module. So what would have happened if it was a success? So in this case, it doesn't make so much sense to use it because if the contact was not created or updated, we would not want to continue over here maybe. But if you want to, if you have a different purpose of this, you could do that. For example, here we could fill out the ID. So we could say like, hey, the contact ID is 32. I just know that. And then okay. And then now when I click save and when I click run once and when I send some data over, then you see that right now here. So we go over here. Then here we got an error. So here we have a runtime error, but then we go to resume. So our directive or error handling directive, and we set this data ID, contact ID is 32. So now when we go down here, you see that output is 32. And because of that, it continues in our scenario to the next module because we have this resume module. So this is one of the directives. It can be quite handy, but it really depends on what you want to use it for. In most cases, I found, at least for myself, that if there's an error, I don't want to continue. So I do not want to do that. But hey, it's there if you need it. Now then, ignore. I think ignore is a pretty simple one, right? So what we can do here at error handling route, then we just say here, okay, ignore. And then we also see there's not any settings. I click save here. I click run once. We go back over here and then our data is being sent. And then, okay, here we still got this runtime error, but because we added here the error handling route and we just said ignore, everything here is still a success. So also now when you go back here and I refresh the page, then you also see here that it says status is success. So if also, if we go here to details, then you see here, okay, the status is success. So that option is there if you want it. Like if you're like, okay, hey, this is actually not such an important module. So if something goes wrong, just ignore it. And then next executions will go on. But you have to keep in mind that if you do this, and if something would go wrong with this module, you would probably not notice until you maybe go into this and then manually look at the execution. So I actually don't like to use this that much. Only what I said, if you have something that is really not so important, then you could do it. But otherwise, I would not really recommend to say ignore. One exception maybe of something that you can do, you can also set a filter for your error handling route. So when you click this, you can just add a filter like you would normally do. But then with a condition, you can also set here the type of error. So you have all kinds of like different types of errors, right? But then you could, for example, here say, okay, if the type is equal to, then here, for example, data error, only then continue to ignore. So if you have a use case for that, then you can also set up filters in there if you want to. So that is the ignore directive. Then we have the break directive, and I think this one is maybe the most confusing one. So the break directive stores the input to the queue of incomplete executions, and the scenario execution is status is set to warning. So if we do that, we go over here, then we say add error handler, and then over here we just say okay break. Then you also see we have some options over here. So if you don't check this, then it will just break and it will do what we set over here. So here it's just going to store the input into the queue of incomplete executions. This is what I usually do when I use this. But if you want, you can also automatically complete the execution. And then what you can do is you can set here, okay, number of attempts. I want it to try 3 times. So then 3 times the scenario is going to start again with the same amount of data. And then this is going to be the interval between those attempts. So in this case, it is set to 15 minutes. So for 3 times, every 15 minutes, so 15 minutes from now, 30 minutes from now, 45 minutes from now, it's going to try again to complete the scenario. But usually, I have to say, I don't use that. I just here say automatically complete the execution, I leave it off, and here I click OK. Then here you see that we get a little red one because we have to change a setting inside the scenario. We can also click this. And then it says, this directive requires storing of incomplete executions to be enabled. So over here, we have allow storing of incomplete executions. So you need to turn that on. And then here I click save. And now when here I click run once and I send some data over, then the scenario will start. And then in this case, you see that we don't get this like red triangle, right? So in this case, we get a warning, and also says that over here, the operation was completed with a warning. And then our break here, our break is like breaking it, like it's like pausing it basically, and it is storing this execution. So we also can see that over here, by the way. But you can also see it in the top here, incomplete executions. Then you see that we have an incomplete execution up here. Then you also see the size. Then here you see also retry and resolved and attempts. So now if you go to detail, then you also see here in which module something went wrong with this like red warning. So here I would just go here, it says 403, okay, we don't have access to this. Then what you can do is you can either like try to fix it. So for example, here I could change this, or if you're like, why did that go wrong? We can just click run once. And then the same thing, the same data will just be sent again, right? So then here we see again, we get an error. So then now when I go back here, incomplete executions, and I refresh this, and you also see that here attempts, we have one. So we have one attempt there. Now if I click detail, and now imagine I would change this to the proper connection, and I click here run once. Then now, boom, you see that it was resolved. And then also here, incomplete execution was resolved. So now when I go over here, then you also see here attempts 2, resolved, yes. And then this incomplete execution will stay here. I'm not sure why that is, but what I usually then do is just like, okay, this is resolved. I don't want to clutter this up. So I'm just going to delete this and then okay. And then we go also back here and then everything's fixed. But what you have to keep in mind, if you do that inside that incomplete execution, you make a change and then you're like, oh, hey, actually we have like the wrong connection. You have to keep in mind, you also have to change that over here as well, because otherwise it's still going to break for the next people depending on what it is. So yeah, that is the break directive. So it's a little bit confusing, but it's just storing everything in incomplete executions. Then I want to show you how to use a rollback. So rollback stops the scenario execution immediately and marks status as error. And this is basically also what happens if you don't create an error handling route at all. So if we would just send data now, we also get an error. So it's basically also like a rollback, I think. But here, if I would say add an error handler, then over here we say, okay, rollback, no settings to set. Here I click save, I click run once, I go over here, I send some data, then the data is being sent, and then okay. Boom, over here, we got some error. Here, runtime error, we had a rollback, okay. And then now, when I go over here, we also see that we have an error. And then here, I can click details. And then if you want, you can also see what is up here. But what you have to keep in mind is that, I think this may be handled with the break directive, you can actually go into the module, then fix it and like run it again. But here, you can only see what went wrong. So you only see like, okay, we have an error over here. And then usually it would store it in the queue so that you can fix it and then can like enter people to it again, like I showed you in the beginning of this tutorial. But yeah, that is the rollback. And then what you can also do here, you can also say commit. Commit stops the scenario execution immediately and marks it the status as success. So I think this is actually a little bit like ignore, right? So if you go over here, click delete module, then here add error handler, and then we just say over here commit, we click save, we run once, we send some data, data is being sent, then okay, here we still have our runtime error, and then over here we have commit. So then now, if I would go back over here, you see that we have success. So again, this is not usually something I would use, because then if something goes wrong, you basically don't know about it. So I actually think really the warning is really handy, the break directive, because then it will be stored in incomplete executions. You go in there, you can like change what went wrong maybe. So that is really handy. Now then one more slightly more advanced example that I want to show you is something that you can also do. Like you can really go crazy with these error handlers. We can also set add error handler. And then what we can do is we can also add maybe a router. So here, router. So here we have our error handling route. So if there's an error, we go over here. And then you can also here add a filter. So if you say here, okay, the type is data error, data error, then we go over to this path and then maybe we ignore. If, and then we also should set here the name. So it's just label for yourself so that you know actually what you said there. But if it is something else, some different kind of error. So here, then we say type, just say different kind of error, right? Like you have to check then what kind of errors that could be produced. But then you can also say, okay, in that case, Google Sheet, I wanna add a row and then you can do everything again. So here we go spreadsheet, we say, okay, example sheet. And we select our sheet, right? Like we also did before. Table contains headers. Then name, okay. First name, last name, email, note, different kind of error happened, okay. And then if you want, you can also still add a directive after that module. So you can also say after that you maybe want to break the module, something like that. Here we click save. So yeah, as you see, you can go quite wild with these error handlers. I have to say, I never set it up like this. It's like quite a lot of work to do that for every single module, but just I would recommend to set this up for like really important modules that you absolutely want to know, okay, if this doesn't go right, then I want to do this. But yeah, I hope that this helps you to understand how error handling inside IntegroModel works. And if you still have any questions about it, just let me know in the comments below.